Making a good steam capsule is hard, but it's really crucial to the success of your game. And it's not just one image. There's the header capsule, vertical capsule, page background, and what seems like a mountain of other assets to produce. The header capsule appears at the top of your Steam store page and acts kind of like the cover of a book. It's one of the main things that players use to judge your game's genre and quality. The small capsule is maybe even more important because it appears next to your game when it's shown in a big list, so it can really help you to stand out. So as developers, we have our work cut out for us, and we need all the help we can get. In this video, I'm going to walk you through an invaluable tool which you can use as part of your Steam capsule workflow. Hopefully, you'll be able to get better results and end up with more wishlists and sales on Steam. Welcome to Indie Dev Lab. How do we make better Steam capsules? Being an amazing 2D artist, or hiring one, would definitely be handy. But every artist, good and bad, can improve their capsules using one important helper: reference. Collecting reference images from other Steam games is really important for a few reasons. Researching how other games place their logos and secondary elements in all the different types of Steam images is crucial to getting yours right. And there are hidden tropes that games use to sneakily signify their genre to players. For example, a lot of crafting games have a hammer hidden somewhere in their logo or artwork, which helps to tell players that this is a crafting game and they should expect lots of crafting. But collecting reference images from Steam games is, frankly, much harder than it should be, because the images are scattered across the store in different places. For example, the vertical capsule only appears in one place, the front page of the entire Steam store, and even then, only if the game is in something like a seasonal sale, otherwise it's impossible to navigate to. And some images, like the library image assets, only show up in your Steam library if you buy the game. So if it's so hard, how do we collect all the reference we're going to need? To solve this problem, I made a simple tool called Steampoacher. It's a free website that anyone can use. So how do we use it? Let's say you found a game that you want to check out. Go to the store page for the game and copy the URL to the clipboard. Now go to steampoacher.com. You'll see a random game here already, but to see the game you're interested in, paste the URL into the top box and hit enter. You get the header capsule, small capsule, main capsule, vertical capsule, page background, as well as those library image assets, which only appear when you have the game in your Steam library. Just right-click to download the ones you want. So that's the basics out of the way, but there's a few subtle features that can be pretty handy. If you're confused about what each image is used for on Steam, hover over the image and it will show you a tooltip with that information, along with the expected dimensions of the image. If that's not enough for you and you need more information, hit the little I button which appears above each image to go straight to the Steam developer documentation for that image type. If you're collaborating with other people, then rather than sending them all the images, it's quicker just to send them the Steampoacher URL for the game you want to share, and then they'll be able to download the images on their side if they want to. The site is fully optimized for mobile, so you can work from your phone or tablet. And it can be deployed as a web app too. On iPhone or iPad, just hit the share button and press add to home screen, and then it will be accessible just like a native app. There's something similar on most Android devices too. And that's about it for this video. If you have any questions or suggestions for Steampoacher, then feel free to leave them down below in the comments. Other than that, I'll see you next time on Indie Dev Lab for more game dev tutorials. Thanks.